up against John Richardson, everyone. John Richardson. But it says, until recently you lived in Swindon and your hobbies include cooking for one, solitaire and gently weeping yourself to sleep.
As you can imagine, I've never seen this show before. Not really my sort of thing, quizzes. Too busy out banging.
Are you, you're a big fan of the show, right?
Well, I've dressed up like it's my wedding day for a reason, Jimmy. In that it should be the best day of my life, but there's a chance I will be humiliated beyond all repair.
You can see John regularly in 8 out of 10 Cats, Stand Up for the Week and the Meals for One section of his local supermarket. In 1998, chess player Garry Kasparov was beaten by supercomputer Deep Blue. But later this year, John will seek to prove that there are still some tasks beyond modern technology when he takes on the computer at Match.com. John's friends call him Rico, which goes some way towards explaining why I've never heard anyone call you Rico. In 2003, John was living as a lonely, friendless, unloved single man in Swindon. But all that's changed now. John now lives in London.
I don't care. I'm on Countdown again.
John is as happy as Larry. Unfortunately, Larry has had some very bad news. John's very much the thinking woman's comedian. If the woman in question is thinking, maybe if I go and hide in the loo for half an hour, he'll just leave. In 2011, John released a book about his quest for love. Before it, he hadn't had a girlfriend in 8 years. And after, he's not had a girlfriend for 2 years. So, some improvement there.
The joke's on you, Jimmy, because I have got a girlfriend.
Well, she must be made up.
She's blown up, to be honest.
John turned 30 last year. He celebrated the big day with all his friends alone in his kitchen. It's John's 10th anniversary as a comedian, so what better way to celebrate than by getting you a... drum roll, please. We got you a drum roll. Hope you liked it. John has a new girlfriend. She's everything he could have ever imagined. She's imaginary.
You know so much about me. I haven't told anyone it's 10 years since I started doing comedy. I've told everyone I've got a girlfriend, I'm not going to lie to you.
Well, 10 years since we Googled you.
Does it say on there, does it?
Well, it says when you started doing comedy and we worked out, we got Rachel to help us with the maths. 10 years.
Wow.
Happy anniversary.
Thanks, mate.
John used to live alone in Swindon, but now he lives in London with all his friends. Big Ted and Big Bag Dave. John's got himself a girlfriend at long last. Congratulations to everyone involved. For the online dating industry, getting John a girlfriend was the equivalent of finding the Higgs boson. John is widely considered to be the life and soul of the party. Well, I say party, it's really more of a get-together. It's actually a wake. But John is the life and soul of it. John's got himself a girlfriend, so for him, the long years of feeling lonely, disappointed and angry are over. Although for her, they're only just beginning. It must be difficult for John's girlfriend to date someone with OCD. Every time she gets turned on, John turns her off again.
That is the best one you've ever done.
Thank you very much. John describes himself as a double door checker, as he's paranoid his front door isn't locked. Don't worry, John. Pretty sure it's locked. You definitely locked it, right?
Don't start because I wasn't the last one out today.
I'm sure it'll be fine. Can you smell gas? Did you lock the door, though, when you...
Well, no, I didn't, because she's still in and she's told me to stop locking the door when she's in.
Have you genuinely locked people in the house?
If she's asleep, I'll double lock the door.
Anyway, if John switched off the stair lift, there's no way she can come down anyway.
John once described himself as a perfectionist who finds failure difficult to handle. I just wish we'd known that before we partnered him with Josh.
This is one!
Here's a fun fact for you. John Richardson backwards was a medical diagnosis made when he was 8. This is interesting. At school, John was captain of the book team, which is another way of saying king of the virgins.
I was captain of the book team at primary school, and I think I find everyone was a virgin at my
John phones his mum every single day. Keep on trying, John. One of these days, she's bound to pick up.
You know when you have people around for dinner, is this how you introduce them? Joining me tonight is my friend Steve, who's got a small dick.
John shoots all his clocks fast so he's never late, and it works. Of course, the other reason John is never late is because John is never invited.
I was invited here.
You keep turning up. John's been going out with his girlfriend for a year now, which might sound good, but I've lost a tenner. Stand-up comedian, writer, radio host, is there anything John can't do? Yes, he can't leave the house without checking the gases off 15 times. John's girlfriend's been with him for nearly a year, and if John's girlfriend is watching, there'll be a helpline number up on the screen at the end of the show.
What a shame, Jimmy. You delivered those perfectly, but it's been over a year, and I have an electric hob. So the joke's very much on you.
John has a habit of meticulously organising the coins in his trouser pocket according to size, is what he told the arresting officer. Do you do that?
What, wank outside or order my coins?
Do you order your coins?
Yeah, I do.
I think everyone
does.
It's
just fun, though, isn't it?
It's just fun. John's a lucky man. His girlfriend's brilliant. She's funny, beautiful, intelligent. She looks amazing first thing in the morning. And I love that thing she does with her tongue.
Say what?
John and Josh are friends in real life. Normally, when you have two good friends, there's a funny one and a good-looking one. What's happened here?
That's unfair, because everyone else just got jokes about themselves, even when John's... It's about me.
You're sort of a victim.
Shouldn't be sat next to the alpha, should you, mate?
John has been going out with his girlfriend for over 12 months, and to mark their first anniversary, her friends and family released a special video message pleading for her safe return.
Quite enjoyed that.
When it comes to Countdown, John's a real winner, though I doubt that makes up for the rest of his life. John is dedicated to his girlfriend. She's a lovely, bubbly girl whose parents describe her as missing. John hates tech speak. The abbreviated spelling and poor grammar infuriate him, and if John were to ever receive a text message, I imagine he'd be livid.
I do get text messages from Papa John's Pizza Hut and my bank. The joke's on you, Jimmy, cos it's two for Tuesday.
John says his new girlfriend takes his breath away, and that's because she's inflatable. Yes, John Richardson, hilarious, brilliant and confident are all nine-letter words John might get tonight. Did you just count up the letters in all those words?
I'm still working on it. Biting my tongue long enough about the fact that a robin is a hedge-dwelling bird and not a tree-dweller. But...
Our Countdown captains couldn't be more different. While Sean Locke loves to let his hair down, John is famous for letting his family down. The thing I love about that is it's massively harsh and just made up.
This is the start of a new series. I assume the next episode you're just going to say, John's a dick. Looks according to his mum.
I'll write that down. That'll be very good for the next one. John is really good with numbers, as opposed to women, conversation and emotions.
It's always like, we always do jokes about everyone, and the audience laugh. And when you do my ones, everybody laughs. How would you go before you'd even finish that one?
I didn't laugh.
Thank you, Jack. I shall return the favour.
Okay. John should try his hand on the X Factor. He can't sing or dance, but if you're looking for tragic backstory, he's world class.
Well, I can sing and dance, actually. I just keep that very well hidden.
Let's have some song and dance. Come on, break it out.
And I think that'll do. It's important to always leave them wanting less.
OK, I shouldn't be mean. John was actually bullied at school, and to this day, he still washes his face in a flushing toilet. Look, the bigger boys are laughing at you.